What's good, young boy? Nah, I ain't doing nothing. I'm just out here chilling, bro. I might actually go hoop. What you want? Here you go. Yeah. Bruh, who cares, bro? You the one who hoops it. Bruh, I ain't hooped in probably like 3 or 4 months. I guarantee I'll kill you. Okay. All right, put money on it. You just got paid today, put 100 on it. Oh, you got bills to pay now. You can talk all that trash, but you got bills to pay now, huh? Bro, I'll kill you. Matter of fact, just come over. I'll kill you. We'll videotape it. And whoever win, you got to buy me the next 2K. How about that? Bro, you the one who all confident talking about you could kill? Come through. All right, bet. People, and welcome to the only place in the universe that supplies you with fuel for your dreams, goals, and entrepreneur ambitions for the free Reality TV. Today, we are going to be reviewing Jay Williams' Life is Not an Accident for my bookworm review. Okay, so Life is Not an Accident, a memoir of reinvention, is about Jay Williams. Many of you guys may know he's a college basketball analyst for ESPN, but before his career at ESPN, he was a Duke basketball player, an NCAA champion, a two-time National Player of the Year, and was drafted number 2 by the Chicago Bulls. But had his life altered by a motorcycle accident. And the book just takes you along through his journey, trials, tribulations, and triumphs. Pop quiz, people. Who has the most NCAA national basketball championship? I really enjoy how this book reads. It's from his perspective. It's his voice. So you're seeing the whole story through his eyes. And I really enjoy books that are, you know, written in that way. They're very easily digested. And honestly, I finished this book in like a week just because of how great it was. And you see things through his eyes, just the detail. He'll talk about when he first went to Duke, the conditioning, how he felt like he was about to throw up in his mouth because he had never conditioned like that before. Or, for instance, when he was on a road trip with Chicago Bulls, he would see husbands kissing their wives. And then on the plane, he would see them setting up, you know, dates and stuff with their side pieces on whatever city they were going through. Or even from his motorcycle accident. Just the excruciating pain he was feeling, how he describes that, how he felt like his insides were falling apart as the paramedics were putting him on the board. So just illustrations like that in the book are what really, really captivate you, and what I really enjoy about the book that kept me going for more like page turner, you know? And then also just the stories he shares in the book are really captivating as well. I don't know about everybody else, but stories really get me into it, you know. And he was just sharing all types of stories, as you guys will find out when you read the book. Stories like when him and Chris Duhon's another NBA player, but they had a tournament. They took an hour ferry at night when curfew was in act just to go party and turn up with some girls from another basketball team that they had learned. So they had to take the ferry back. Had to play like 2 or 3 hours later, just reeking of alcohol. Stories like that he shares, like his draft party, His mom invited all his past girlfriends to his draft party. So he's walking around with his girl, and then he sees this girl, and then that girl. And it was just, how he describes it is just so crazy, so funny. And then it even gets darker than that. The details of his accident, and the just it was deeper than the injury, how he suffered for years, just abusing drugs, abusing relationships, and even attempting to, you know, take his life. In the book, just illustrations of stories like that are what really are going to hold you guys into the story. Just going to keep you wanting to turn the page, keep you wanting to read it, and before you know it, you're going to be finished with a book like I was. Life is Not an Accident is just a roller coaster of a book. It just shows Jay Williams' demons that he had in him, the perseverance that a person has to have, and how your highs can be extremely high and your lows can be extremely low, and how life can just snatch that stuff from you, whether you want to or not, whether you realize it or not. But at the end of the day, what I ultimately took from it is that's just a part of life. And the more that we accept that these highs are coming, these lows are coming, and that at the end of the day, it's part of the journey to create the best us that we can be, the better off you'll be in life. So I definitely give this book a great read. I recommend it for everybody, man. If you're in a dark place, this is also a phenomenal book for you to read, just to see how he came out of his struggle. Or just, you just want to read a story, a genuine 100% story about someone who has been at the top and who has been at the bottom. So definitely, once again, rate this as a great read. And the answer for who has the most national basketball championships is UCLA with 11. So thank you all for the support as always. Make sure you're hitting that subscribe button. If you haven't already, comment, you know, share, all that good stuff. I love the feedback. I love it. Keep it coming. Message, email, anything like that. Hope you guys enjoy this book. Let me know what you guys read it, what you guys thought about it as well, and some of your opinions. So, once again, see you guys next week, next month. And you know, just get out there and dominate, man. Dominate in the universe. Life is not. Peace, guys.